Great, and once again, good afternoon. I haven't been on the show recently. This is your Not Your Average Joe show. This is a show, the Joe. Ya se me olvidó el nombre en español, en realidad, ¿no? El show de Joe, un show único. Único porque es un show en inglés y español. We're Not Your Average Joe show because this is a bilingual relationship building, educational, whatever you want it to be show, right? And today I'm very, very pleased to have with me. Today we're going to be, I guess we used to call this, we're just getting down and shooting the bull, talking about whatever comes to mind. I apologize, I haven't been online lately. Some family health issues have arisen over the past, since the last broadcast date. And finally, those have been taken care of. Everybody's in a better place. For the first time in 2 years, I also had the opportunity to see my nephew, my only nephew. And so a lot of it's occurred on the personal side. But today we're just, like I said, here to talk. A lot of it's going to be focused on the presidential race. As a Latino, and my friend David here, both people of color here, we would be negligent if we were not discussing that in some fashion, huh? Y esto show hoy va a ser una discusión de la elección presidencial que vamos a tener pronto, en noviembre. Si no está registrado, necesita registrarse, se puede hacer por la computadora, por internet, o busque personas que son las personas que registran personas para votar. Sea usted en cualquier condado que vive o cualquier estado que vive. If you're not registered to vote, I think that's the first requirement. If you're in Texas, go down to your, usually it's your tax collector assessor's office, voter registrar, you can do that on your own. Fill out a form, you also can look for people like David who are registered deputy voter registrars, and they will assist you and fill out the forms. So the first process is participate. You have to register. Primer proceso es registrarse para participar en esta elección. Va a ser muy, muy importante, especialmente para nosotros que somos pobres, que somos de diferentes comunidades que no necesariamente nacimos aquí, pero sí estamos aquí para ayudarle, para discutir el asunto. So once again, register to vote. Is that right, my brother David?
Absolutely.
This is Mr. David Mitchell. He's program services for a long-standing nonprofit here in Galveston County, which certainly does not limit its services. They provide services, I know, to people at various times from across the country. That's the nature of the world today. And so how's your effort? That's a personal journey that you're on, to make sure you get as many people registered.
Absolutely. It's not just to actually have a high number or percentage increase of individuals that actually register, but to educate and inform and make sure that those that are actually registering understand the significance of what they're doing. Because most of the time when we're talking about registering people, it's for a national election like the presidency. But what people fail to understand is the importance of the local and state elections as well, because we are not as educated and as informed on what policy making entails, what it is, what it entails, and the connection between that of becoming a registered voter, electing individuals that are going to hopefully reflect decision making that's going to be a benefit to the community at large. A lot of people don't know that. They don't understand how the presidential election is important, but so is the local and state.
El señor Mitchell nos dice que no solamente las elecciones nacionales son importantes, pero más para nosotros aquí, las elecciones locales. Esas también tienen una gran importancia. Necesitamos participar si queremos una voz. Eso empieza en participar en la elección de miembros de la Cámara Estatal, el Senado, Casa de Representantes aquí en Texas, o alcalde en su ciudad, o miembros del Consejo Municipal también. Todo esto es de muy, muy importante participación local, y eso es algo también que se requiere que se registre primero. ¿Y cuál es el requisito? Nada más que sea un ciudadano. Solamente es un ciudadano que puede votar, que puede registrarse y votar. So, I'm reminding everybody too that it's only U.S. citizens that can register to vote. And that's another reason why we have, like, in the United States, approximately 3 million individuals that are permanent residents who are eligible to become citizens. And we're seeing a huge number of them finally deciding to become citizens so that they can now have a voice, especially in the presidential election.
Excellent.
On that side. If occasionally I fall into coughing spasms, I'll pop another cough drop.
Well, let me see if it's a tribute to the social issues of
April. I've got to brag about my brother David here. It's not too often these days that you see people that are willing to go out and sit on a street corner, not to solicit people. Let me say that. But David's out soliciting. but he's out actually forcing people to think about their role as residents in this country.
Well, I think that that's very kind of you. Yeah, but I'm not doing any more. You haven't done it, are doing it, and will continue to do it. I think that there have been some factions in our nation alone that want to make sure people remain disengaged, that they not be as knowledgeable as they should and could be. They want you, the less you know, the better it is for them to continue the foolishness and the degradation and dehumanization of some of the issues of impact that are facing us.